Okay, we're gonna have a bonus conversation because I've been reviewing and I don't like what I'm seeing with my dogs. They're not progressing as fast as they really should. And the things I'm finding are that my feeding position is incorrect. I'm consistently feeding wide and forward. The good news is that you should internalize the fact that even pretty good trainers do things wrong. So I'm pretty used to rewarding my dog on the left-hand side. I have pretty good muscle memory over there, but I really don't on my right. So I'm learning just like you'll learn, and I'll get better because I have videotape. So by watching the tape, I can say, how is it possible that for, I think we're at 3 weeks now, 3 weeks of working on this right turn pull right, or turn away pull, that I'm still struggling? And the answer is that my feeding position is wrong. So when you have a problem that doesn't go away, that's consistent, something needs to change. So the kinds of things I am going to change going forward and have started changing today and a little bit yesterday. Brito's arousal level is a little too high, so I'm lowering the quality of the food. That'll help. Lara's arousal level is a little too low, so I'm seeing what I can do about increasing the value of the food, which is not simple because she's not really a food dog. I am really concentrating on this hand position, keeping it here and feeding in this range, not here. And trying not to be so casual. Every once in a while I just put a cookie in, really working to put the cookie in the side of the mouth. The other thing is, because it's that forging thing that's kind of consistent, is hand behind your back. So cookies over here, you just slide there, feed there. That will help. This is my right. I mean, today was clearly an improvement for Lyra. So just becoming conscious of what you're doing is huge. But the thing to remember is, if you're working towards change and you're not getting change, then training is not taking place. And then the solution is to say, some questions you ask, is the dog engaged or disengaged? Start there. That's a big deal. So she's engaged. They're both engaged. Are they content? Are they happy? Or are they distressed? I would say neither dog is distressed. If your dog is distressed, you need to look at your rate of reinforcement and your clarity. Because dogs that get upset, and Brito does sometimes if you watch him, it's usually because they're not sure how to win and that frustrates them. And then, are you progressing towards your goals? So those are your questions. And what I observed is I had the first two, but I'm not progressing towards my goals. And so now I'm going to change that a little bit. And I think what will happen as a result is I will make better progress in the next few days. So we'll take a look and see how we're doing. Good girl.